यशोदनन्दन व्रज नरञ्जन यमुनातीरावनचारि विहारी
गोपी जनवल्लभ
जय गोपी जनवल्लभ गिरिवरधारी
यशोदानन्दन
व्रज नरञ्जन यमुनातीरावनचारि जय राधा माधव
वासुदेवाय
ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ॐ नमो భగవతి వాసుదేవాయ
నారాయణ నమస్కృత్యం
నారాయణ నమస్కృత్యం నరం చైవ నరోత్తమం
దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం
దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం తతో జయముదీరయే నష్టప్రాయేషు భద్రేషు నిత్యం భాగవత సేవయా
భగవతీ
ఉత్తమ శ్లోకే
భక్తిర్భవతి
నైష్టికీ
శ్రీమద్ భాగవతం కాంటో 7 చాప్టర్ 13 టెక్స్ట్ 29 Today we are ready. 29. Jalam tat udbhavai channam.
Jalam tam udbhavai channam.
Hitvagyo jalakamyaya.
Hitvagyo jalakamyaya.
మృగతిష్ణాముపాధావేత్
మృగతిష్ణాముపాధావేత్
తథా న్యాత్రార్థ దృక్స్వతః
తథా న్యాత్రార్థ దృష్టతయా
జలం తదుద్భవయచ్ఛన్నం
జలం తద్భుదవయచ్ఛన్నం
హిత్వాజ్ఞో జలకామ్యయా మృగతిష్ణాముపాధావేత్ తథా న్యత్రార్థ దృక్స్వతః జలం తదుద్భవయచ్ఛన్నం హిత్వాజ్ఞో జలకామ్యయా
మృగతిష్ణాముపాధావేత్
తథా న్యత్రార్థ దృక్స్వతః
జలం తద్ఉద్భవైశ్చన్నం జలం తద్ఉద్భవైశ్చన్నం హిత్వాజ్ఞో జలకామ్యయా మృగతిష్ణాముపాధావేత్ తథాన్యాత్రార్థ దృక్స్వతః
జలం తద్ఉద్భవైశ్చన్నం
జలం తద్భూద్భవైశ్చన్నం
హిత్వాజ్ఞో జలకామ్యయా
మృగతృష్ణముపాధావేత్
తథా న్యాత్రార్థ దృక్స్వతః
జలం తద్ఉద్భవైశ్చన్నం
హిత్వాజ్ఞో జలకామ్యయా
మృగతృష్ణముపాధావేత్ తథా అన్యత్ర దృష్టతః
జలం
తద్ఉద్భవైశ్చన్నం
హిత్వాజ్ఞో జలకామ్యయా
మృగతృష్ణముపాధావేత్
తథా న్యత్రార్థ దృక్స్వతః
జలం
వాటర్
తద్ఉద్భవై బై గ్రాస్ గ్రౌన్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ వాటర్ ఛన్నం
కవర్డ్
హిత్వా
గివింగ్ అప్
అజ్ఞః ఏ ఫూలిష్ ఎనిమల్
జలకామ్యయా
Desiring to drink water.
Mrutrishnam.
A mirage.
Upadhavet.
Runs after.
Tatha.
Similarly. Anyatra.
Somewhere else.
Arthadrik.
Self-interested.
Swata. In himself. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada.
Jai.
Just as deer, because of ignorance, cannot see the water within a well covered by grass, but runs after water elsewhere, the living entities covered by the material body does not see the happiness within himself, but runs after happiness in the material world. This is an accurate example depicting how the living entities, because of lack of knowledge, runs after happiness outside his own self. When one understands his real identity as a spiritual being, he can understand the supreme spiritual being, Krishna, and the real happiness exchanged between Krishna and oneself. It is very interesting to note how this verse points to the body's growth from the spirit soul. The modern materialistic scientist thinks that life grows from matter, but actually the fact is that matter grows from life. This life, the life or the spiritual soul is compared herein to water, from which clumps of matter grows in the form of grass. One who is ignorant of scientific knowledge of the spirit soul does not look inside the body to find happiness in the soul. Instead, he goes outside to search for happiness. Just as a deer without knowledge of the water beneath the grass goes out the desert to find water, the Krishna consciousness movement is trying to remove the ignorance of misled human beings who are trying to find water outside the jurisdiction of life. Raso vaisa, raso ham apsu kanteya. The taste of water is Krishna. To quench one's thirst, one must taste water by associating with Krishna. This is the Vedic injection. Om Jnana Tivrandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshur Viltam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manavishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamriyam Dadati Swapadantikam Namo Mahadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishna Krishna Chaitanya Nami Gaurapise Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tatpatanche Chaturangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sate Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Lilam Vrishyamalako Malangam Sita Shamaro Pitabham Bhagam Pano Mahashayak Charu Chapam Namami Dhamam Raghuvan Sanatam Nilachala Nivasaya Nityaya Paramatmane Baladeva Subhadravyam Jagannathaya Te Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna
Hare Krishna
yesterday we read, I want to read the text lesson from yesterday's, that the Santi person is explaining to Prahlad Maharaj about the material body and happiness and condition of the soul. Last verse was, in this way, the conditioned soul living within the body forgets his self-interest because he identifies himself with the body. Because the body is material, his natural tendency is to be attracted by the varieties of material world. Thus, the living entity suffers the misery of material existence. Krishna bhuliya ji bhagavan cha kare nikatastha maya dar jhapatiya dhare. In Chaitanya Charitamrita described that when the living entity, he forgets the Krishna and he desires for material enjoyment, and that moment he is captured by maya. That is the point when he is captured by maya, and then he suffers. He becomes conditioned. And here, the example is given, also it's called Mrig Marichika. Mrig Marichika. You know, when in desert, the mrig, the deer, it runs one place to another place to find the water. And also, there is a called Kasturi saint that lives in the neighbors of the mill, and he is trying to find out all over the desert, but the story scent is there in his neighbors. He never realized that the smell is coming from just within him. So similarly, the living entity is trying to find happiness in the material world, but because the living entity is a part and parcel of Krishna, and Krishna is always happy, you know, full of happiness. Satchitananda, full of eternity, full of knowledge, and full of happiness. But because the soul is not trying to connect himself to Krishna, and is trying to find happiness outside of Krishna consciousness, you can say, outside, in this material world, and he is never happy. Because happiness is not there. He is covered by material things, material elements, material desire. That's why, you know, he is saying, just as a deer, because of ignorance, cannot see water within a well covered by grass. The water is right there, but because it's covered by grass, so deer cannot realize that the water is here, right here, and I am thirsty, I am trying to find water and running here and there in a desert where there is no water other than this well. So, and same way, but runs after water elsewhere. The happiness is here, but we are trying to find happiness in drinking wine, you know, easy sex, eating meat, gambling, and other so many engagements we are trying to be happy. At the end, the result is that no one is happy. No one is happy. No? Krishna Bhulia ji bhogavan cha kare. We desire material enjoyment and different kind of hope. But we are more and more entangled. More and more we are entangled in this material world. It's very difficult to come out. But as soon as someone is connected with Krishna, in one sense, we can see when the soul is in original spiritual position, he's always happy, you know. But when he comes in this material world, and he's covered with so many different desire, and the gunas, triguna, satogun, rajogun, and tamogun, then becomes unhappy. Then he's looking for happiness. Why you are looking for happiness? Your original position is to be always happy. Prasanna, always happy. The living entities covered by the material body does not see the happiness within himself. The soul is pure. Krishna is pure and soul is part and parcel of Krishna, so he is also pure. But he is covered by material body. Yasyat buddhi kudapetra dhatuke sahi kalatradi subham ichati. He said that. That those who consider this body himself, and body is made out of kaf bhapit, so sahi kalatradi subham, and he thinks that body is himself. And the kalatra adisu, the wife and the children and home and other outer things, that he thinks that they are mine. So the scripture says, Saiva Gokhara, that person is not better than cow and ass. Gokhara. Sahi kalatra adisu bham ijadhi. I forgot the one line. So, Saiva Gokhara. And as soon as he's like a go and khara, then he has to struggle in this material world. He has to work very hard. You know, everyone is working not for himself. If you ask somebody, why are you working so hard? Oh, I have my family, I have my, relative, I have my son, this, that, something. I'm working for them. For what? You are doing for what? You are doing for them, but what you are doing for yourself? Nothing. Like Mrigari, you know the story of Mrigari? Mrigari, he was working and he was killing all these animals just to maintain his family. But he was not doing anything for himself because he was soul, but he was not realizing it. He was thinking, the whole body and soul, there's no difference. He himself is a Mrigari, that's it. And the family members, his duty is to protect them. So he was killing animals. But then when he realized, after Narada Muni asked him to go and ask, this is simple activities you are doing, and ask them if they can share your sin. When he went to wife and kids and father and other family members, he asked them, oh, I'm doing so much sinful activities just to maintain you guys, And when the suffering will come, are you ready to share the suffering? They said, no. Why will you share the suffering? This is your duty because you are my husband, you are my father, you are my son, you are my this, you are that. This is your duty to maintain us. Oh, then he realized, because the soul, in the scripture he said that alone he takes birth, alone he works, alone he suffers all the karma that he does. No, alone. No one is, even husband and wife and kids, and they are together, but still everyone is individual. Everyone is suffering individual. No? In the same way we are sleeping, husband and wife, husband becomes sick. Or maybe husband wants something else to drink, maybe milk, and wife wants to drink water. Then the desire is separate. And the karma is separate. He becomes sick, she's alright. Or she becomes sick, he's alright. She suffers. So, every individual has their own karma. We alone take birth, we alone die, alone suffer, alone do all the activities in this material world. But we think that we are together. That is a covering of Maya. So, when Mrigari realized that, then he said, okay, now I want to do bhakti. And he started bhakti. When he became devotee, he became more happy. And also, there was no tension of maintaining his family. Everybody, whoever coming to see him, bringing some grains or some potatoes or whatever, vegetables and fruits. And the story says that after some time, he became like so much ingredients at his home that he doesn't know what to do. that he has started fruitful life, feeding so many people. In the beginning, he was doing so much simple activities just to maintain himself, but he was not able to maintain his family. But when he became devotee, he started fruitful life. See, this is the thing. So then he became more happy, you know, and he was not even killing ants. When he was walking, Narad Muni saw, my disciple is coming. And Narad Muni was with August Muni or some Parvat Muni, someone. And then he said, look, before he was killing all the animals and half killed, he was enjoying when they were half killed and they are suffering, then he was enjoying. Now he became so nice, wonderful sadhu, that even he doesn't want to kill one small ants. That is the difference. And he became happy. And he was thinking, everyone, all the living entities, is a part and parcel of Krishna. They all belong to Krishna. Why I have to disturb them? No more killing. That's why Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita that apichetsu duracharo bhajate mamananda bhak. Even the most sinful person, that he surrenders to me, bhajate mamananda bhak. Sadhu revasa mantabya samagya hivivastita. It is sadhu, he is supposed to be, he should be considered as a sadhu. Sadhu person. Abhichetsu durachara. Maybe simple in this material world, but when he surrenders to me, ananya bhava means only me, not here and there. Only me, he surrenders to me, my lotus feet. Then he becomes sadhu. And the next verse is said, Chipram bhavati dharmatma susanti nigasyati kaunteya prati jani name bhakti apanishati. That kind of devotee never vanquished. That kind of devotee. Constantly serving me, thinking about me, doing my bhakti, devotional service. And within no time, he becomes dharmatma. Chipram bhavati dharmatma. The sadhu, he becomes dharmatma, you know. The other day we were discussing about sadhu. There also, Lord Kapila Dev is describing, Mai ananya bhavena bhaktim kuranti dhraha. He is describing. And ananya bhav is everywhere. Sattam kirtayanto maam, ejana parimpasate, desamitri bhaktanam, yoga mayacham. You know, everywhere is shame. So we have to fix our mind, Prabhupada, like a wife, you know. Prabhupada gives example many places that a chaste wife in the house, she's serving everyone, even in-laws and other family members and relatives. But when the point comes to give her mind, she only gives her mind to her husband. So the devotees also, we have to respect everyone, but to give our mind, we can only give it to Krishna. That is a chaste wife. So in that way, if we surrender to Krishna, we will become happy and Krishna will protect us. That is saying, Name bhaktya pranasati. That kind of devotee never vanquished. That means what? I protect him. Many times we have seen, sometimes devotees, they get bewildered. Then somehow Krishna, of course, those who are very elevated soul, Krishna comes and protect them. Otherwise, the other less elevated, some devotee comes and protect him. So it's like that. Somehow Krishna is trying to protect his soul. And at that point, the soul becomes more happy. So, does not see happiness within himself. We have to see the happiness within ourselves. So that means we have to realize that Krishna is full of happiness and we are part and parcel of Krishna. And as soon as we will connect ourselves to Krishna, we will also become happy. So no need to find happiness in outer worlds. Outer world is full of misery. If you go and try to find happiness, there is no happiness. There is all miseries. But runs after happiness in the material world, he's saying that. Runs in the material world, we're trying to be happy. And we can analyze ourselves. Like every day we are working. Some people working day and night. You know, yesterday one person came and I asked him, please come on Sunday. He said, I'm working every day. Then I asked him, where you work? He said, I work in a restaurant. So restaurant means Sunday more crowd. Yeah? No holiday for him. You know, he lives in some racist town or some that area. Nice couple. But because they are working every day, they don't have time to come to temple. Every day you are working for what? But if you analyze that, the 12 hours, we are working 12 hours, you know, from morning to evening, just to become happy. Nobody is working to become unhappy. But at the end of the day, if you count how many hours you become happy and how many hours you become unhappy, then you will find out of 12 hours, 11 hours you are unhappy. You know, 11 hours we are unhappy, but we are working to become happy, but we are not becoming that much happy. This is the life. So in one day, or month, year, you know, in this way we are working whole life. You know? That's why Sa eva Gokhara. Gokhara means animals, like animals. Khara is ass, donkey. He works so hard. What is called, washer man, he carries, in India I have seen sometimes they carry anything, whatever they want they carry. Even the bricks they carry, and stone they carry, and the sand they carry, you know, and wood, cloth, anything you put. And this donkey is carrying, you know. Why? Because he's thinking that this washer man, if I don't work, he will not feed me, you know. If I work, he will give me grass. So Prabhupada said that if he is intelligent enough, the grass is everywhere, he can go and eat. Why he has to work so hard? You know, the living entity is the same way. There was one story I read a long time in the paper, newspaper. But the story was very much, you know, like fresh. That there was one couple, husband and wife, Brahman. They were living in the forest. One day, the Brahmana, he said to his wife, you know, in Hindi, he said that, Sandhya aane wali, the darkness is coming, Sandhya, evening coming, Sandhya aane wali. So, you finish your all the works because it's going to be dark. Sandhya aane wali hai, tum ghar ka sab kaam samapt karo, jaldi jaldi. So there was one lion passing by, you know. Then he heard that this Pandit, this Brahmin is talking about Sandhya. And he's also saying that Sandhya aane wali hai, sab kaam jaldi jaldi niptalo. So maybe Sandhya kya hai? There must be some extraordinary big something, you know. So he got scared, that lion get scared. And because of this fearless, he sat down there. And dark, you know, naturally became dark, and Brahman was innocently saying that Sandhya aane wali hai, tu apna kaam sab kar lo, because now in the Sandhya bandhan and evening time in the forest there is no light, no electricity and all this, so it's better to finish our work during light. You know? So, after some time, there was one washerman washing cloth in the river, and in the dark, his ass was somewhere misplaced. You know? Somewhere he went somewhere and he was trying to find his ass. So, in the dark, he was trying to find his ass. He came, you know, near a lion, and his, you know, he had one stick. He hit with the stick to lion, you know. Lion said, oh my god, Sandhya Marti bhi hai, you know. Sandhya beats. And then he was, you know, he became more scared. And in the night, the washerman, he put all his clothes on lion and lion was caring because of the fear. So, the moral of the story was, the soul is a lion, but because he never thinks that what is sandhya, why is he talking about what sandhya, and we are never interested in this, and that's why we have to work like ass. The same as the lion is not meant to carry cloth, you know, he's king of the forest, but because he did not use his intelligence, so he has to work like ass. So the every living entity is a part and parcel of Krishna, and Jivare Swarupa Hai Nitya Krishna Das. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that every living entity is an eternal servant of Krishna, that the relationship we have to realize, you know. And but because we don't think of that relation and we don't want to think, we are not realizing it, we have to work like as in this material world. You know? At the when our original spiritual, what is called, constitutional position, we are always happy, you know, satchitananda, full of eternity. Of course, this is eternal, soul is eternal, and body is never eternal. Is dead, already dead. Since the soul is there and Paramatma is there, that's why it's working. Otherwise, it's dead. And full of knowledge, you know. The soul is full of knowledge, but still when it comes in this material world and is covered with the material things, he has to go through so many processes to get some little knowledge. And of course in material knowledge, we are working so hard 20-30 years to acquire this material knowledge, and after another 20 years that knowledge is no use. Government will retire you. Okay, now you retire, your knowledge is no use, now next generation will come with a different technology, different knowledge, different ideas, and they will work. It's like that, you know. Then the knowledge, the vidya we are acquiring, we are getting with so hard struggle within this life has no use. Material knowledge I'm talking about, you know. And we are not interested in the spiritual knowledge. That spiritual knowledge is for soul, you know. Soul goes from one body to another body, that knowledge also goes from one body to another body. He travels with us. Paramatma is always with us. You know? Wherever we go, we are in human form of life or animal form of life and bird, beast, whatever, Paramatma is with us. And the spiritual knowledge is also with us. Like there is a story in the Bhagavatam, Bharat, Jad Bharat. When he was king, Bharat Maharaj was king, he was very learned personality. He was son of Krishna. And all the sons, the 100 sons, they heard the Bhagavatam or the philosophy or the Siddhanta from his father. That means the God himself, he described all this knowledge. Nayam deho deho bhajan riloki kastan kamana rati vidhujan. And he was so learned personality, he was very advanced in his spiritual life. But because of attraction with the deer, he has to become deer next life, you know. But the knowledge he acquired in the previous life was still in the deer's body. He could understand, oh, what I have done, such a big mistake, you know. He was supposed to go back home, back to Godhead. Now because of the deer, I became deer. He could understand in that body also, you know, because of spiritual knowledge, spiritual bhakti. And then, after giving up that deer body, he became a Brahman, you know. But in that Brahman also, his name was Bharat. And his name was Bharat, and he could understand there also. The knowledge was there, remembering everything. Then, he thought, this life, I am not going to act like a intelligent or bhaktai or what. I have to become like a mad, like a jada, you know. So that's why people used to call him jada. Jada means fool, you know. He doesn't know anything, you know, unconscious person. doesn't know what to do, where to do, when to do, and he was just walking like a jada. So people used to call him Jada Bharat. So we say Jada Bharat. Jada means murk. So, and he was very intelligent, very advanced. When he would never speak, but when even that point, some this Adivasi tribal, what is called, people, they catch him to sacrifice for Durga. He never said anything, okay, whatever. But because he was a devotee, Durga came out and protected him by the mercy of Krishna. But when he found a suitable disciple, he spoke about soul and body and so many, big lecture in Bhavatavi, all material world and everybody. He talks about to Raja Raghugana. So this is the life. We have to be very, very careful. Krishna says, Antkale cha mame va smaran mutva kalevara. Anyone who remembers me at the end of his life, he comes to me. Because he was remembering a deer, he became deer, So, Jaya Sri Sitara Madhava Bhagavan ki. So he became deer. So Krishna said, if anybody remembering me, they will come to me. Tasmat sarveshu kalesu maham smaran yudhacha. That means, he is saying that you do whatever you are doing in this material world, because you have to be here, you have to live there, you need something, to survive. So you do your work, your business, your everything, but maham smaran, just remember me, He is saying, Arjuna, yudhacha, fight, but remember me. Always think of me and just go to fighting, So same thing he is saying, that we are fighting. We are also fighting in this material world. Prabhupada is this world struggling for existence. We are struggling for existence. We are fighting for existence. So, we have to struggle. There is no other way. But Krishna said, just remember me all the time. Think of me. Always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. That is a formula. Sattam sattam smaratabhya Vishnu vismaratabhya na jati chit. Always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. So this is the things we are discussing here. That this is Prabhupada saying that the life or the spiritual soul is compared here in to water, is compared. The water, the happiness is right there. But we are, so that's why Prabhupada said, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. So we have to chant Hare Krishna and be happy. Hare Krishna. Sorry if anything wrong. Yes, Prabhu.
Good question. Where's the reference of the animal killer?
It's in Teaching of Lord Chaitanya, TLC. Teaching of Lord Chaitanya book. The story is given there. The Mrigari. Mrigari, Mriga means the deer, and Ari means enemy.
Is it
an enemy.
Bhagavatam?
Is it not in Bhagavatam? I am not seen in Bhagavatam. But it's in Chaitanya Charitamrita.
Really?
That's why it's there in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Teaching of Lord Chaitanya book. So he's there.
So how he, under what qualifications he had that he could become elevated to become a sadhu?
Mercy. He got mercy from Narada Muni. He got mercy from Narada Muni. Because Narada Muni, he's a transcendental spaceman. He's traveling all over the universe, He was just passing by through that forest, and when he could see that all these half-killed animals, they are suffering so much. Why they are suffering? He also couldn't figure. Then he had to know, who is this? Who is doing this, all this? killing anybody. Okay, if you want to kill them completely. They will die and the suffering is finished and maybe they will get another body. But suffering is there also, but as a new baby bird, there is less suffering, you know. And suffering comes later on more. So the soul will go to different body and maybe, okay, that's all. But if you half kill, it's more suffering. You know? And regarding all that, when the animal was suffering, he was enjoying. It's more painful, you know. You kill somebody in one shot, that is different. But if you kill slowly, slowly, and the person is suffering so much and even enjoying, that is very cruel. Very, very cruel. So Narada Muni, because of pure devotee of Krishna, he became so compassionate to these animals. You know, Sadaiva Dayadarsita Pasughatam. It's said for the Lord Buddha, Sadaiva Dayadarsita Pasughatam. Kesava Dhrita Buddha Sadhu. Buddha also came when he saw these animals were killed in the name of sacrifice. So Narada Muni became very compassionate. And then Narada Muni is, of course, is capable to turn anyone into pure devotee. So he thought, let me give some mercy to this fallen. Because he could see that after death, after giving of this life body, where he will go, Mirgari? He is going to go very, very degraded hellish planet, hellish condition of life. So he became more merciful. So he gave mercy to him. And then he was elevated. And then after he became devotee, of course. Believe.
In this life, he acted a very dumb person. So is that like, you know, his purpose was higher purpose, spiritual purpose, of course. But is that like falsifying yourself and you know, how can you like live a life like that?
No, and he's just trying to avoid the problems. He's trying to, because he knows that by little sowing, little becoming compassionate to this deer, baby deer, he was so much entangled, you know. He lost the opportunity to go back home, back to God, and now he has to take one, two birth, you know, a deer birth, and then another human, a Brahmin birth. So maybe his intention is to not to mingle with so many people, because other people, they think that if it is jerk, if somebody is dumb, the crazy people, they are people trying to avoid it. You know? But if he becomes so nice, everybody will call him. You know, you see, in the Bhagavatam, we say that his father, Jagrat father, was trying to teach him, you know, a karmakanda. Because other brothers, they were karmakandi. So father was thinking, oh, my other son, they are very much expert in karma kanda, they are living nice life, but my this son is so dumb, you know, so mudha, you know, he cannot do anything. So at least let me teach him some karma kanda so at least he can live nice life. But he tried whole life, but he could not teach him because he doesn't want to learn, you know. And when he died, then he said that Sudeva Goswami is saying that Brahmana should not die in the home. They should go out of the home before they die. So by this Brahmana was trying to teach his son, whole life he was thinking about his son and family and all this, and he died. So the Jadbharat, maybe he doesn't want to be entangled again in this material world. That's why he doesn't want to mingle with him. But it's not falsely. He knows, by knowing him, he is doing all this. I don't want to sit with some mundane people, those who are literally attractive people, you know, so much materialistic people. Like, Nyavilashtas, you know, there is another shloka, I forgot that. You should not do associate with the people who are with the mundane desire and mundane materialistic people. So that means not it's not falsely we are thinking that. We try to avoid that sangha because we want to advance in the spiritual life. Otherwise, what? Mundane people, we only talk mundane things. So it's like that.
So it's exactly what you were saying about acting foolishness and mainly to avoid contact and intermingling with others. So.
Like if somebody is a pure devotee or somebody is trying to advance in spiritual world, spiritual life, they have to be full in material world. Otherwise, you become more expert and intelligent, and then the pride will come, and will be more and more and more and more into material things. You think, oh, I know everything. And some people say, why? I don't need anything. Why I have to go to temple? I have everything. I have my education. I have money. I have house. I have wife, family. You know, I'm big post holder. I don't need to go to temple. Beg something from Krishna. They say sometimes people talk like that. They're so proud. That's why Kunti Maharani said that Aishwarya is not good for a spiritual life. But Aishwarya sometimes is good, but if some devotee have, they use it for Krishna service. Also, the money is called altar. Bahari pran, Buddha is bahari pran. There is a soul inside, that is pran, and there is another pran, money. That money, pran is not there with you, then what do you do? That also you need. But the thing is, we don't have to be too much into it. And devotee, they utilize everything for Krishna service. Otherwise, the materialistic person, they use everything for their own self. That is not good. So devotee is trying to avoid associating with materialistic people. That means not there. He's not, you know, proud or something. He's not ego or something. He's trying to avoid because he wants to do bhakti. Instead of if you want to advance in the spiritual path, then you have to have less friend. For example, if you have 10 friends and you're chanting in the temple. So everybody will disturb. How are you? One time, another, how are you? 10 times. But if you have one friend, he will only ask you one time. That's it. So less friend when you're chanting, you know. So that means less problem. This the big celebrity, they have more problem. They cannot even walk on the street. You know. One day I remember in Bombay, before, in the beginning, we have an auditorium, and we used to give to those film shooting, you know. So Amir Khan came, you know, he came to our temple. And as soon as he came to the lobby, in the guest house lobby, so many people, girls, boys, you know, they run after him, you know. If their bodyguard is not there, they will just snatch him everywhere. These people, they will just... They want to touch him, they want to hug him, they want to kiss him, you know, like this. This is not a love, you know. They don't know what he's feeling. Everybody's trying to, you know, and he's trying to like this, you know. So, he become more famous, it's more dangerous. And like we can walk whole world, nobody knows. You know, so it's like that. So, less devotee, less entanglement. Less friends, you know, we can advance more. So maybe that's why Jan Bharat was thinking that I should not mingle with anyone. But when he found a suitable person, Raghugana, he was discussing with him. Mahajanayan, how they said? Mahisam Padvajogisekam. He was the duster, the lotus feet of the pure devotees. The only way by which we can advance in spiritual.
Okay. Just one point. Sometimes what happens is devotees may take it in a this kind of Chadabara story in a different sense. Say, for example, some may interpret it as like, for example, I'm living in my life, but if somebody comes and sits in a class and listens to such a verse, he gets bewildered.
like, what am I doing in my life? And they take it in a negative way, right? Sometimes they say, okay, I should not serve my family. I have to focus on my spiritual life and I have to leave it like that. Sometimes I've seen some of them do this, and that is wrong, right? Because we have to follow our dharma. Our dharma, currently I'm in a grihastha life, so I have to follow the dharma in grihastha ashram, right? So in that case, then I have to follow my spiritual activities, also take care of my family and bring them up in spiritual life. So there is a dharma that I have to follow as part of my ashram also. So I cannot leave my dharma too, because otherwise I cannot artificially jump into being in a brahmachari mode, right? I cannot become a brahmachari. It should be natural for me to be in such a situation.
We don't have to become pretender or something.
Yes.
We have to be truthful to ourselves.
Yes.
Even Jadbharat, when he was king, he was taking care of his family and whole
kingdom.
What is called kingdom, planet, whatever, you know. When he decided to go to forest, he did not just leave everything and just went to forest. No. He gave, he distributed the kingdom between his brothers. You know, you take care of this, you take care of that. He made sure that everything is okay. Everyone is taken care. Everything is taken care nicely. Then he left. Alone he left to do bhakti. It's not that just give up and just go. Some responsibility also we have. There is a paramarth and vyavhar. In the material world, we have to be, what is called, vyavharic. How you say in English? Vyavhar. Etiquettes. So in vyavhar, there is a relation also. There is a father, mother, wife, kids. We have to take care of them also. But in paramarth, we always have to think about that our everything, pita, vasto, janto, mata, dhata, pita, maha, Vedam Pavitram Karanam Samjadirvacha, everything is Krishna. These living entities, because of our karma, now in this life, someone has become your husband and wife and kids and mother, father and relation. So that also you have to perform nicely. That you have to take care of it nicely. You know? This is also the responsibility given by Krishna. And that was our desire also. Because of our desire, because of our karma, this whole system designed, relationship designed, you know. Karmana deva netrena jantur deha prabhatyate. Because of our karma. So we have to follow that also. We cannot give up everything. If someone is grihastha, that I am talking about. Brahmachari, he should only think about Krishna and read the Vedas and all this. Sannyasi also. And vanprastha also, he should practice more and more detachment. But grihastha. So, that's why Krishna says, Mamasmaran Jiddhacha. That means, Arjuna, you are a warrior, you are a fighter. You fight, but you remember me. So, we have to see the same way, we have to do our duties, take care of our families. At the same time, we have to do bhakti. So, in this material world, we have to follow the vyohara. If someone is father, he is going to be father whole life. You cannot change. Even if you say, you are not my father, but still he is your father. Right? So why you have to say, no, you are not my father. You are my father. I must respect you. You know? But at the inside, for Paramarth, the one should 100% be convinced that my original father is Krishna. But in this life, okay, because of this person also I got this body, I have to respect, I have to serve him. But every time when I come this material world, I get one father, one mother. There is a brother, there is a relation with so many people. Eh? So, who is my original father then? This life his father, next life somebody else's father, other life someone else's father. So, original father is Krishna. Krishna himself said, Pita Aham. My father himself. Aham Bija Prajampita, I am the seed giving father of all living entities. So, his original father, we have to think this way. And we have to take care of him. And at the same time, we have to progress in our spiritual. We cannot give up. Otherwise, Krishna will not like it.
Jadabhati is not a ghost.
Third life, he was.
In the beginning, when he was king, I think.
Yeah, king is.
Even when he in his third life, he was totally neglecting everyone.
Yeah.
Even in Nectar of Instruction, it states that we shouldn't try to imitate and try to totally become silent. That is also not good. We should. Because we cannot imitate that. Even if he becomes silent and if he try to do that, it's not
he was not silent. He was not silent. Just in ninth offense, what is that ninth offense? To instruct a faithless person. So when you get faithful person, what do you say? You instruct. But when you get faithless, then you don't.
No, but his father was not a faithless person. Right? He was still
they were Kramkandi. They were Kramkandi.
Brahmana, his father.
Even to get attachment in the family also, not good. You have to take care of them, that's it. But don't be attached. You know, some people are, you know, I have this true story. In Allahabad, there was a jewelry store, and one brother went to the store, he opened the store, and then the gundas came and they shot him. He did. And the other brother, when he came, when he saw that my brother is dead, he also died. By seeing him, he died. So much attachment, you know. But just by seeing him, he also died. So two brothers died. Like that. So we don't have to become that much attached. Okay, take care of them. Death and birth and always and disease is going to come. And these are all in the hands of nature, Prakriti. And Prakriti is under direction of Krishna.
Because in Bhagavatam also it states that one can fully be dependent, only when one is fully dependent on Krishna, then all these relations, you don't have to really, what to say, necessarily put effort to take care of them. Only when we are fully surrendered. But until then we are still responsible for, based on our desire, whatever we have got around us.
Like a Krishna story, when Krishna was in Dwarka, he was taking care of everyone, you know. He married 16,108 wives and he built 16,108 bungalows for everyone, each separate. You be happy, whatever you want, you know, you get. They have children, everyone get children and house and all the paraphernalia in the house, everyone. And all the inhabitants of Dwarka, Vasi Dwarka, they were very much dependent on Krishna for all kind of protection. And Krishna was protecting them from every kind of danger. But when time came, you know, Krishna to show them, show the detachment, you know, he was very much detached. He said to that one place, you know, and he knew that they are all fighting and dying. You know, but he did not go there. No, why you are fighting? He could have stopped them. But no, because he was not attached with them. Of course, he is Krishna, he knows their future also. What is there, where they are going, they are going to his, you know, kingdom. But he was showing that, okay, when time is to take care of the family, you must be a good person and very concerned and nicely take care of them. But when time will come, try to get out from there also. It's not that die there, and you know, Krishna also could have gone there in the fighting, and you know, some maybe different story. He died, or who died, you know, he could have gone and fight with Balaram. Balaram, Krishna, the same level, they can fight. Lifetime, then you know, who will be defeated? You know? But he was sitting at the one place and let them go. You know, they're coming. That was that. This is the lesson actually. We have to learn. We have to take care of our family, but at the same time, we have to practice detachment also.
One of the purports for the rice community, like in generally in the material world, we don't have to teach them how to take care of family, how to, you know,
yes,
like run the family, because by naturally they know all these things and they are so much attached. That's why in the spiritual books, they all talk about detachment, and because this is the art they don't know.
Yes.
So from that perspective, what a...
Like in Ramayana, he said that Prat Kal Uthike Raghunatha Mat Pita Guru Nama Himata. Every day, Lord Ram, he wakes up in the morning and he will go and touch the feet of Guru and father and mother. Every day. And he was so attached to his father, Lord Ram, you know. And mother, father, they used to love him like anything. But when time came to go to forest, you know, he knew that if I go, my father will pass away. He knew. And his father was crying, you know, please don't go, don't go, don't go, don't go. But, you know, that time he saw the detachment, even. Because he could have also said that, okay, I'll stay back now. You know, just start the ceremony and I'll become the king, you know. I'll take care of mother Kekai, you know, Anbharadhanavali. No. At that time, he saw the detachment. Tektva, how is that slogan is in Bhagavatam? Tektva, sudasya surakshita raj lakshmi, you know. Dharmishtra arja, arja yadgarana nema, something in the slogan like this. Tektva, sudasya surakshita raj lakshmi, the opulence in Maharaj Dasarath's house was that even the demigod they were desiring for it. In the heavenly planet you don't find that kind of opulence. The paraphernalias, you know. But Lord Ram, Tektva Sudasya, it's very difficult to give up for the demigod also, and he give up just like that. It's in the 11th canto, that slope is there. Dharmishtha Ardhivachasa Yadgar Aranyam. You know, he went to the forest. Maya Brigam Dhavas Dhavasakti Mandhavan Bande Mahapurushte Charnaradina. And the story is there. Maya Brig is a Marich, he was running after that Maya Brig. He gave up such a, you know, house that it was full of opulence. He gave up just to go to the forest, just to sort of detachment. He was very mad. The whole Ayodhya Vasi, they used to love him like anything. But when he has to go to forest, you know, he was so much in love with Mother Sita. But when this Vasaman said that, oh, you know, everybody knows this story, then he has to give up the Sita, immediately call Lakshmana, okay, take her. So we have to become like that.
We have to live our life. First, we have to learn how to give up so many things. In that give up process, everything is coming. Material, then family members, and then our emotions too. Because everybody, we can leave everybody. But until the death, we are not trying to learn how to detach our emotion. Because if I am a mother, at the deathbed also I am thinking about my children. But that I have to learn. That's why only when the children are growing up, we have to make them independent. And more than that, we have to give them spiritual experience, what we are getting. Because if the God is helping the Narsimheta or Mirabai or Dhruva or Prahlad, then if I am very much deeply involved in my spiritual life, then God is helping me. That experience if I have in my life, here and there, if we will look back, it's called the Sinhavalokan. If we will do the Sinhavalokan of our life, then we will find out so many incidents where nobody helped us, but God gave us the guidance. I won't say the help, but guidance. See, you do this, you will get. You do this, you go there, you will get the answer or you will get the guidance. So that experience we can share with the children. And this is the way we can become little bit detached from
emotions. Tyaga Shanti Anantaram, Krishna said, Tyaga Shanti Anantaram. Tyag, detachment. Tyag me, bahut ananda. If somebody is practice the detachment, he will become happy. Bhog yunda anand nahi. Attachment is painful. suffering. So, as you khate, you eat and you go to toilet. You can live without eating, but you cannot live without going to toilet. You know? So that's why whenever we try to buy some house or flat, we see kitchen and we see toilet also. If there is no toilet, you will not buy the house. Right? Why? Because we are accepting so many things in this material world, at the same time we have to practice to give up also. Tyaga. So this family life is the same thing. We're accepting that the baby born alone, and then he grown up, then he becomes friend of so many different kids. Friends, friend, my friend, my friend. Then after my wife, then my kids, my son. You know, then my son. He was nothing. You know, he did not have nothing when he was born. But after some time, maybe 30 years, 40 years, so many things. Husband, wife, house, money, car, this, that. You are getting everything. You're taking. Only taking. But you have to practice also to give up. Otherwise, if you don't go, only eat, then you will suffer so much. You know, you will die. So, also one example, like we are building a house. So before we build the house, we keep the door, right? It's not that when you make house completely, then you open the door. It's not like that. When you start making house, first thing, you leave the place for the door. So, okay, if somebody is into family life, it's okay. But at least keep one door open, so when time comes, you can go out. You know, we in the house, we have to have door. So just to go out and just forest. Itvat patam grihamanda kupam. Like that. So it's not, the family life is not a bad thing. Even in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Brahma said, Karna Muni, that if you are agree to marry, you become Grihastha, and if you follow the Grihastha system, Krishna will be pleased, is Brahma said. Why? Because the Grihastha system is made by Krishna. And if somebody is following that, he will see that, oh, this person is following all the rules and regulations of Grihastha Dharma, then he is becoming here. Very pleased.
And in our Vedas it says the Dunya Grihastha Ashram. All other ashrams we have to follow, but they give too much importance and priority to fulfill all the duties for the Grihastha Ashram. Because of the Grihastha Ashram, only other three ashramas are surviving. Indirectly, we are giving them more or less little bit support, then only the sansar chakra is going. And one Srimad Bhagavat Katha, one Vakta says that you decided to go to the top of the hill. Okay, you will go there and then you will stay over there. How many years or how much time you will stay over there? Then you will decide. You have to decide or you have to come slowly, slowly down. The same way in the life. That's why only the 100 years, Rishi Muni says that 100 years. So 1 to 50 years up to the Grihastha Ashram, then slowly, slowly come down from the hill as a Vanaprastha and then the Sannyasi. So hill and valley. Hill and valley. This is the life of the manushya. And that we have to follow. That's why only the Vanaprastha is the best. Because when you are going up the hill, you are enjoying more and more. But when you are coming down, it's very dangerous. Because you have the slippery ways. And going up, you can make little bit balance. But when you are coming down, it's very slippery and very dangerous. You have to be more conscious. That's why the Vanaprastha is the best ashram. So that will make us to go back to the God. You came from the God, go back to the God. So be careful. Don't make any mistake. And each and every moment and each and every bit you can use for the bhakti.
Haribol.
Haribol.